Here on another Saturday, I'm going to try and show you some gold leaf technique with my number 6 scroller. Once again, my daughter Lily is filming this for me. And I'm going to show you some technique on gold leaf size. The size product that I use is called Rollco. I found it to be the most user-friendly stuff. It's a quick, dry gilding size from Rollco Labs. It's the best stuff I've ever used. I've used Hastings and all the old stuff. It thins with mineral spirits. I have a little bit in my cup. I've already added some smooth stroke, a couple of drops, and this is all the imitation gold I'm putting in. Now if I was doing silver leaf, I'd put it's not even a drop, it's a half a drop of imitation gold right in with this. All it is enough to tint it a little bit. I've already laid out my design on this flat black plastic tank shell. These are excellent as far as displaying your work, but I've laid it out with a Staedtler Omnichrome. I'm going to put the sizing on and allow a half an hour to 45 minutes. We're going to actually shut the camera off and come back and show you how to gild. And I'm going to give this just a clean wipe to get any sort of residue left and hopefully not create a static charge. So we've got a little bit of thinner. Actually mineral spirits. I'm loading up a number 6 because I want a kind of a fat line, because we're going to do what's called burnishing or spin finishing. I've made this burnishing tool out of a piece of velvet, and I put a piece of cotton inside and then wrap a rubber band around this. This enables me to gently spin the leaf to create a swirl effect. And you do this in a uniform stage when the leaf is all laid on, and we'll go into that. We're going to try and get this into the 15-minute allotted time, so we're going to be taking breaks between. Okay, so I'm going to start at the end, right here. I'm going to fatten some of these lines up a little bit, but that's the basic design. It's a simple flame layout. I'm going to outline this. I believe we're going to use a fire, not a fire red, a bright red. I've got a drip over here. I'm going to clean that with a little bit of alcohol. I'm cleaning my brush and lacquer thinner, and we're done with the gilding. We're going to be using a 23 karat gold leaf that I've actually cut into strips. Can you see that, Lil? And the leaf is on these sheets. It's very, very delicate. It'll come off the sheets if you're not careful, but only because I'm doing line, and that's why. I get all my leaf from a place called Frame Masters. Their phone number is right here. It's 310-652-9300. And the fellow to ask for is David. They've sent me this to use, and it's beautiful 23 karat gold leaf. With a little bit of alcohol, I'm going to clean this drip. That'll prevent anything else from sticking that I don't want to stick. And that's it. Go. So it's been about an hour and a half. This size takes an hour to 3 hours to set up. I've done it in as quick as an hour, but it's been an hour and a half, so this should be really good. The best way to test it is with the back of your hand or the back of your finger, and it should just be a little bit tacky. The leaf comes in a booklet like this, and these are the sheets. They used to make gold leaf each sheet by hand. This will float. This is real gold. If you drop it, it'll float. I've cut the sheets in half so that I have less waste. Once again, it's Frame Masters. Their phone number is 310-652-9300. Ask for Dave. Tell him you saw this video. Okay, so now I'm going to put my glasses on and we're going to start laying the leaf down. As I said, I've cut it into strips. And we're going to try and do this so it's not too messy. And save all the scrap. What I'm using, I've been using the same one for about 20 years. This is a makeup brush. I don't know how you use it as makeup because I don't do that, but they're very, very delicate bristles and always keep it dry. And you can actually pat the leaf down with this. Now there's a Gilder's brush that you can use also. I've never used one, never owned one. Use some of the scrap that I have. Oop, see how it floats? you can give it a little just gently. I've got a heater on under my desk here in Phoenix because it's cold today. And I'm a big puss as far as being cold. I have no use for it. I'm going to try and get it down real evenly because that's how you do gold. It's nice to have the sheets lay down perfectly. That's why they use a Gilder's brush. The sheets will actually stick to the hairs and you can actually almost brush it on, but you can see how light this stuff is. It doesn't make any difference what size. There's no benefit to trying to save any of this because of the gold value or any of that stuff. It's just when I'm taking it off, a lot of times when I'm doing a larger job, I'll set up a vacuum so that I can suck all the flakes up, because you don't want these flakes around when you're putting the paint on. I mean, you can see this. I'm going to shut the heater off because it's actually generating too much wind. I learned these techniques from a guy named Burton, who's got 11 cars in the Indy Hall of Fame that he did. He's from Indianapolis originally. Worked in a lot of race car shops. And, I've done quite a few race cars with this stuff. I'm going to clear coat this. I'm going to put on a brush on clear. I'm going to use the Rollco size. They were supposed to send me some of their new clear that they have. That's a you can thin it with mineral spirits, but it never got here, and I had a film date that I had to do, so we're not using their size. I'm going to try it. I've never used it. They just told me about it. See how I can stick that right down. And when this all gets down, I'm going to make sure that it has no holidays or areas with nothing. You can see all this gold all over the place. You can put it down with your finger. This is a simple graphic design in gold leaf. And I'm going to wipe it clean before I start any outlining, because if I don't, this is going to get everywhere. And you don't want it in the outline. You try to work as clean as you can with this. I'm in my office, so I don't know if this is the best situation to do this in. Okay, so should be able to get the rest of this with one more full sheet. Once again, this Rollco size, I've been using it now for about 2 years. John Hanekane talked to me about this, and he told me it was his favorite, so I tried it. We share ideas, and it just is, I love the size. See, now I have little spots that aren't covered, so I'm going to just go back with my finger and cover them. And then I'll show you a trick to burnish this stuff. All right, I'm pretty much done with this gold leaf, so I'm going to put it away. And it may seem like there's a lot being wasted, but there really isn't. For the amount that you charge for a job like this, it's a very small investment. So now I take this makeup brush, and all I do is go like that. Not hard, because it breaks away. It only sticks to the area that you've got burnished. But you get the edges as clean as you possibly can, and filled in with no holidays. Okay, so there's our design, and it's a simple flame design. You can actually wipe this down. Any areas that you have that are stuck like that, there's no telling why that's stuck there. Maybe I had a little on my fingers or something, but a little bit of mineral spirits.